Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 3 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So, last episode we talked about how you can very easily sort all your items in a Logistics Pipe system, and basically how a default route works. So, today I want to get talking about how you can set up a requesting and a supplying system, so you can not only sort your items in a Logistics Pipe system, but also get them out of it again automatically. So let's get started. So just to make it clear for you guys, I pretty much marked off what I did in the previous two episodes and what I did or what I want to talk about today. And pretty much everything that's red is what I talked about last episode. So if you missed any of that, be sure to check out the link that's in the description below. So that's pretty cool. And everything that I marked blue is what I will be talking about today. So like I said, I will be talking about a couple of things. Basically the requesting logistics pipes, both the normal and the Mark II. The remote orderer logistics pipe and the remote orderer that's connected to it. The supplier logistics pipe and the passive supplier and the active supplier module for logistics pipes. Pretty cool. So first of all, I will talk about the two different types of modules, the active and the passive supplier pipe. Pretty much what passive and active supplier pipes do is try to keep a certain amount of items in a specific inventory, just like the regular supplier pipe. Basically, there's one big difference though. The active supplier pipe, as you can see, you just need to specify what items you want to have in it, just like the active, just like the passive one. But the active one will try to pull items from a network automatically, and the passive one will only redirect items to the chest once they are actually put into the network, and then instead of being put in one of these chests, automatically being sent through here. So if they are already in one of these chests, they won't be sent back into the system. So let's demonstrate. So if I get myself, for example, a stack of wool, and I would put request items wool in this thing, passive supplier pipe, and then sort into the network, you will see it will automatically be sent into this chest. This thing is just saying like, yeah, I need the wool in this chest right here. Pretty cool. Don't you think? I like it. So where did the rest of my wool go? It went right here because it is set to keep the rest of the items stuck to Minecraft. So it will only send the amount that you specified into the passive supplier. In this case, only one block. For example, if I say 8 and then send more into the network, you will see it'll send 8 into that direction and the rest will be dropped off in the specific chest that I specified right here. Pretty cool. But what would happen if I would say, for example, instead of passive supplying, I want to actively supply, 16 wool right here? You will see it gets automatically pulled from any connected storage network to the inventory that you hooked up to this chassis pipe with the active module in this thing. Pretty cool. So pretty much you can think of either of these two having a specific use. For example, active can be used for anything that you want to automate, but not have everything of your system be redirected to. For example, the passive one can be used for, query input. Automatically specify all the ores that you want to be passively supplied, and then instead of being them routed into one of these networks, just send them to the passive network for, you know, being able to be processed. So yeah, pretty cool. So then I want to talk about requesting logistics pipes. This is probably the thing that I would assume you guys like to see the most, because this is the device that allows you to request items from your network on your own. So, like I said, I have a normal and a Mark II request logistics pipe right here. And the only real difference between these two is the speed that they can pull out of. I believe the regular request logistics pipes pulls them out at 8 at a time, or 16. And I would assume the Mark II would pull out a stack at a time. So, that's pretty cool. So, what I can do is if you right-click with a wrench on either of these pipes, you will see everything that it is able to request from the network, currently being 63 stone, 63 dirt, and 39 wool. Why, you might ask? Because in this chest right here, that I specified the basic mod-based items in module to store this thing. I also put in the provider module, which is needed to actually provide the items to be requested by any of these means. So what I did is I specified leave one item per inventory, so it won't take out all the items that are in this chest. So as you can see, I got 64 stone, 64 dirt, and 40 light blue wool. But I'm only to pull out 63 of each and 39 light blue. So this thing is kind of smart and won't actually allow you or won't even show you any more than you are able to pull out of. So for example, I would, if I want to get some stone out of this network, I would just select stone and then the specific amount that I want to see. Or want to request. So you can use the plus and minus button to increment and decrease by one at a time. The big buttons are the double pluses and double minus by 10, and the triple pluses and triple minus by a stack at a time. Pretty cool. So then all you have to do is select the specific amount, hit request, and you will see the items automatically flow through your network into your chest. I believe you are also able to do this if you don't have an inventory connected to it, but that will just spit the items right on the ground for you, which technically works too, but I just like it to be cleaner when you have some sort of chest or something like that hooked up to it. And then again, I can also do the same with, for example, this one, dirt, and it should request it a little bit faster. So yeah, that is pretty cool in my opinion. I don't think you would have to worry too much about all the other stuff yet in this inventory. I'll probably talk about that either later or not really something you should, be too interested in. But I do want to quickly tell you guys about the things that you might want to know. So first of all, there is this sort button, which allows you to sort by different means, like the item ID, the size of the items that you have, either, going up or down, the name, and then again, the ID. Then there is this little pop-up tab, which if you have that selected, once you request something, it will give this pop-up, request successful, but otherwise it will put it in the chest. I usually have this disabled because I request a lot of stuff and it just slows me down. Then you can select what you want to see in the network. Currently, it will show you supply, both, and craft. Pretty much currently in this network, you can only request things that you can supply because I haven't talked about crafting yet. I will do that next episode, so stay tuned for that if you're interested in that. But yeah, just so you guys know, if you want to see stuff that you cannot craft or only craft, you can change that right here. Then content doesn't really do anything, I believe. And refresh just refreshes the content of this network so you don't have to open and close it all the time. Pretty cool. So next up is the remote orderer setup. So pretty much this thing is one of my favorite little tools, as this thing allows you to request items from your network while you are not directly near this thing. So what you have to do is get yourself one of these remote orderer logistics pipes and a remote orderer. They are a little bit expensive as they require some diamonds, either diamond chipsets or, like I said, diamond gears, for example. Then what you have to do is you can connect it to an inventory of your choice. My favorite option is to use an ender chest in combination with an ender pouch, as I'm able to access the contents of that ender chest from anywhere on Earth. So if I put a chest in this thing, for example, it is in this chest too. So, pretty cool. What I'll have to do is get your remote order and right-click to this pipe, the remote order logistics pipe. Pretty cool. And as you can see, once you hover over it, it says has remote pipe, meaning that this thing is connected properly. Then what you can do is just right click with the thing in your hand and you're able to request items from your system wirelessly. So for example, if I want some 20 pieces of dirt, all I have to do is request. It will be sent to the ender chest, and using the ender pouch, I am able to take the items from the network, wherever I am in the world and also across dimensions. Yes, this thing works across dimensions as long as this area is chunk loaded. Pretty awesome. So imagine combining this with another ender chest and an ender pouch connected to this chest. Pretty much so everything you can put in another ender pouch will get sorted into your network. So pretty much you will have infinite control wherever you are in any dimension of what you can wirelessly just sort in your system and again request out of your network. Pretty freaking awesome if you ask me, don't you think? I love it. So then there's one more thing, which is the normal supplier logistics pipes, which pretty much acts like the active supplier module, but it's just a standalone pipe, allowing you to, again, specify what you want to have stored in this network, and it will try to put everything in this network as much as you can do. So either it will request things in bulk of 50, 100, or just as big as possible. Partial will also work, or you can set it to full mode to only request 20 once it is actually able to request 20. So as long as you have only 19 in your system, it won't request it, but if you add one more piece of dirt, it will send it along its path into the fancy network. Pretty awesome. So I guess that is pretty much it for this video, guys. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed, but most importantly found it very educational. Like always, if you have any questions about what you would like to see or what I have done in this episode, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below or send me a personal message, because I always respond to them when I have the time. So like always, thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.